What do we have here? We have a box. And there's a clue. It says R1239M. What could it be? So now we're going to do the unboxing. It's amazing. So, what is it? Well, it is the City Express train set from Hornby. Illustration on the box shows an express train with three carriages, a motor car and a trailer car, and we're going to get some track, a point and a buffer stop, and we're getting a new style Hornby analog controller, a power track, and a switching type transformer of the more modern type. You can see here we've got these three carriages, and we're also going to get a mini mat. The box is held in place by these stickers, so I've got to cut this to release the gum to open the box. Exciting, isn't it? I have moved the camera to a higher vantage point. See what we've got. Well, we have got a MIDI mat, and we've also got a re-ray, a railer, which will come in handy. The one I've got is broken. We've got inside the instructions, the high speed train operating and maintenance instructions, and a little pamphlet saying Building Your World. We've got usual assortment of track, and it's in a cardboard box. Here we've got the new style Hornby controller, which has a forward and reverse, quite a nice knurled knob. And here we have a new style AC adapter. Now, let's have a look at the train itself. This is the power car. I can see that here the are the cogwheels. It has a, on here it has a traction tyre. The windows are smoked. You can't see any, there's no interior detail. But on the front we have got lights. Let's This is the trailer car. Also, it does have metal wheels. And it has a pantograph like this. And here is the middle car, and you can see it has the number 160378 here. It has the same kind of couplings as were sold on the Blue Rapier train. You will notice here that this, if you compare the power car to the trailer car, you will notice they are the same. There's not as much detail in this pantograph as there is on the Javelin, but nevertheless, I mean, it's quite a pleasing set. Well, the next thing we're going to do is going to try this out on the layout. We've now moved to the railway room, and we're going to put the train on the track using this chute that Hornby has supplied. You can see it runs quite freely. Finally, power car. This up. Now the moment of truth, folks. You notice the lights illuminate direction of travel, but also notice there are no red lights at the rear of the unit. Here we're going to just try a speed test. You can see it's able to travel quite slowly. The motor's not too noisy, it doesn't growl or anything. Let's go back. Reverse. So, I mean, you could certainly say it certainly runs quite smoothly. Stop that for a moment and readjust the camera. Now this train is a version of the Javelin train, which I've also got on this layout. I'll just now bring the Javelin into view so you can compare them. And you can see it is very similar to a Javelin train, except that there's a different colour scheme. obviously there's a bit more detail on the Javelin. Let's just move them side by side. Now here you can see, you can compare the two trains. You can see that the pantograph equipment's very similar here as to it is here, but there's a bit more on this Javelin. This part here is marked out, whereas here it's not marked. It's just, I mean, you could obviously, if you wanted to paint this to make it match. The same does seem to be the same level of detail on these mouldings. It just seems that almost the same moulding has been used. But you can see the carriages are exactly the same length. This City Express train is a similar colour scheme to the Pendolino, but it's, as far as I understand it, a fictitious colour scheme. Which train is noisier, do you suppose? Let's try... just to get an estimate of the noise. I think the Javelin train is actually not as noisy. Let's ramp it up to full speed. What we've learned from this exercise is that the City Express train is not as fast as the Javelin. And you can see that the Javelin train is overtaking the City Express by a country mile. I have taken this apart just to show you what it's like inside. It comes away in the same way that the Javelin train, the piece fits on the back, the same. Inside we can see we've got a circuit board to light these lights at the front, and here's the motor. You can see it's only quite a small type of motor, which is not the same motor that's used in the Javelin train. And also you'll notice there's not a DCC socket. I suppose it could be converted to DCC, but it's a, if you are a DCC user, it's a factor to bear in mind when purchasing this train or contemplating purchasing it, is that it is not a DCC ready train. There are two, it's just the chassis held in place by two screws here and here. This piece of the, attaches to this little hole here. This piece at the back comes off. It is the same as the as it is on the blue rapier and there's and the javelin. I don't recommend you take this apart. Once you take it apart, it is very difficult to refit it. Should you be contemplating dismantling this, it's actually only a friction fit. There are two screws here and here, but you don't actually have to remove them to dismantle it. It's held in place by lugs which are here and here. But once you have this, what you have to do to dismantle it is to lift this off here and take this piece off the back, as you would with the blue rapier and the javelin train. That's all you can really say about it. Well, there's not a lot more you can say about this. It costs £100 currently from Argos, and the Javelin train pack, which is coming out shortly, is going to be £123. The latest Hornby Visitor Centre Javelin train pack. So you've only got to pay £23 more to get a Javelin train. But against that, you've got the fact that this train does include a controller and track. So if you are just starting out in the hobby, of course, if you buy this, you've got the controller and you've got the track and you've got a point. So you've got everything you need actually to start on a layout. In its favour, it only has three coaches, so it will fit on a smaller layout. But against it is the fact that it is not DCC ready. And you could only use it with the analog controller supplied. But with the, if you get the Javelin, you've got the option of going for DCC. But on the other hand, if you go for the Javelin and you want to go for DCC, you've got to have a decoder in each power car. So obviously you're going to be adding about another £20 on top of that each end. So you're going to be adding on about another... instead of being 123, you're paying about £150, you know, for the whole Javelin DCC set. So looking at this City Express set from Argos, it is good value and it runs smoothly. So there you have it, folks. Thanks for watching.